Coming up next on C-SPAN, the latest video from ISIL featuring Jihadi Joe.
Welcome to another video by ISIL in our beheading series. As always, I am Jihadi John, and here with me today is an American journalist. His life is in your hands, as we're asking for a few simple demands. First, $100 million in 72 hours, along with the complete destruction of the imperialist West and an end to their arrogant international military policies. Also, we need to reach 1 million followers on the official ISIL Twitter page.
Warning, the following images you are about to see are disturbing in nature. And you know that. You know where this is going. He's holding a knife. He's not about to cut a slice of birthday cake and feed it to this guy. If he was, that would be some actually surprising news. But fine, you want to watch their gross video? Let's watch.
Do not just put a capital IS for Islamic State, because it looks like the word is, which makes us very hard to Google, and as you know, if you're not like the first link on page one of Google, you might as well not even be posting. ISIL is not pleased with the focus President Barack Obama has been placing on our forces in Syria. Mr. Obama, please know that your actions are being watched and taken into consideration as we carefully increase our expansion into Syria. This plan is detailed on our webpage, where you also find our new stock of flags, hoodies, t-shirts, tapestries, all kinds of new sick designs. This is also going to be the first place to premiere our new mixtape with tracks produced by Diplo, Skrillex, JBXX, and myself under the pseudonym DJ Jihadi John.
You're looking it up, aren't you? You're going to go download the mixtape by this asshole from ISIS. Why? You know it's not going to be good. Rap in a British accent is never good. It doesn't even sound intimidating. You want new music? Go to World Star Hip Hop and check out some freestyles. But don't watch any of the other videos on there. You don't need to do that.
European Union, 1 million Twitter followers, and also we need to get that verified check mark so people stop retweeting the fake troll accounts. People need to know which one's a legit account. And lastly, and this is probably the most important one, I request the personal cell phone number of Jennifer Lawrence. And I don't think this is that odd of a request, as she said that she'd have sexual intercourse with Larry David, who's a Jew, so I think compared to that, I'd be quite a prize. Now, not only do I think that we'd probably have a lot of similar interests, and like, it'd be chill just to get like brunch and stuff together on a Sunday, we could also have like a cute celebrity couple's name in the media, like Jihad Law, which, if you ask me, I think Jihad Law has a good ring to it. Now, finally, let's get to the reason this video's even being watched.
Well, here it is, you sick fucks. I guess this is what it takes to get you internet weirdos to watch C-SPAN, huh?
As always, follow Jihadi John and ISIL on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, like us on Facebook, and be sure to click the link at the bottom to subscribe.
Live from New York, it's Soap!
It's Soap Does Comedy! With Andrew Benedict.
Mr. T, I'd be more like Mr. Coffee. Maybe Mr. Cappuccino. But seriously, I told my mom I was in a new wave band. She said, hey, I thought Surf Rock was dead. Told her I was gonna be a comedian. She got sadder than Morrissey.
Aaron Coughlin.
Most female things you'll notice seem like instruments of torture. Have you ever really worn high heels? They don't seem to be conducive to feet or to walking whatsoever. You're standing up and your toes are mashed.
Ben Hosley.
Enrique, I heard you were dating recently. How's that going? It's okay. Who have you been hanging out with? Who have you been seeing? Bears? Bears? You can't date an animal. That's crazy, Enrique. Oh, no, it's big, hairy gay men. Oh!
And Joel Straley.
I don't say it's right to suck my own dick like this! Mom's knocking at the door! I'm gonna cut it out, Mom! Be down in a second! We're having meatloaf! She says, bye! I got my own meat in my mouth right now! I don't need your meatloaf! the pig say on a hot summer's day?
I don't know. What did he say?
I'm bacon. And I have pneumonia, just like 82% of all pigs raised on factory farms.
Oh.
Somebody who just loves to learn, and the other pair grows up to be somebody you just love to chew. Pa loves the both of them, you see it's in the pulp, yeah. Both kids living back at home, even though they're grown, hey, it's a family of pets.
In front of a live audience of fruits.
Pa, have you seen Bosk?
Yeah, he's really let himself go.
No, is Bosk home? Actually, it's 1 p.m, so I'm sure he's still...
Boy, did I sleep well.
Sleeping.
Now, Bartlett, I know what you're gonna say.
Where is my car?
It might have got impounded.
And I might be the Queen of England.
Oh dear, Your Majesty, where are my manners?
Stand still! I'm gonna punch you!
Oh no! You broke 80's prize vase!
You got any last requests?
Get around! We gotta fix this toilet! But remember, no monkey business! Hey, you!
What'd I do?
Get to fixing! Hey, you're doing it wrong! Hand it to me!
I'll hand it to you!
I'll get it off your head! There you go!
Remember, safety first, guys.
Let a professional do it. Screwdriver. Ratchet. Scalpel. Bull. Lighter. Pizza crust. Dildo. Puppet.
I'm a chef, I don't fix toilets.
Quit cluttering around! We gotta step on it!
I'm your man! Uh-oh!
Oh no, fellas, he's stuck!
Don't flush, I can't swim!
I can fix it!
Stop, he's out!
Where's Aaron?
Let's make a break for it. This way, you dummy!
My shrink boot!
Boy, that girl really knows how to handle a hammer. Like I have sex, not well. Then some woman ends up dead in my apartment Wednesdays, huh? And another thing, did anyone else expect doo-doos to come out of that broken toilet? I mean, I've seen some shit before, but this right here, takes the cake. It was taken earlier after lunch. She's really got my eyes.
Taz always takes huge shits.
Now, I bet a bunch of you disgusting viewers at home are probably like, Taz, that's not that big, or I take way larger logs, Taz. Well, maybe, just maybe, you're up for the challenge.
Yo, it's Taz's Big Poop Contest, yo.
That's right. I want you to put your money where your butt shits and tweet us a picture of that dung and hashtag it, Taz wants to see your poop.
Taz wants to see your poop.
That's right. I want to see that duty. And you can win awesome prizes for just $1.99, like a month free of tanning, a lifetime supply of Tazbees, and all of Mumford & Sons CDs.
Oh, sales are final.
All right, up next, something probably homophobic.
Hey, why did the blonde get E. coli?
Well, I don't know.
Because she was one of 72,000 Americans who contracted it from eating beef last year.
Pass.
Who you boys gonna be dead when she sees this?
Hey, did I leave my wine over here? Ooh, watch this man.
Creeps, you gotta help. Auntie Angie's gonna kill us.
Quick, Grapes, get up on that pile!
Okay, but you're gonna owe me a box of Rosie. This is important. Hey, this hurts, Grapes. Oh.
Say, Auntie, that's a real nice apron.
Oh, hey, babies, how was your day? Hey, where is my vase?
Ugh, old people living with two bachelors? It's like, why don't old people just die already? Toad soup's gross.
Taz hates the elderly.
Well, it's like my parents. It's like, talk about a pair of assholes who are all mad because I burned the house down. Or, like the time I tried smuggling cocaine across the border and their dog. I mean, the bag unsealed, the dog's dead. I'm just trying to salvage what's left of the coke. Or, the time I hired a shady doctor to convince them that I was sick and needing a kidney, so I could sell my dad's kidney on the black market so I could buy a new spoiler for my Honda Civic. Anyway, pull up your adult diapers, because this week on Rules, we're talking old people.
Tazzy's rules.
Okay, rules number uno. Over 30? Get out of here. You're basically dead. And the way I be drunk driving, yo, I should be dead by 27, hopefully. Much respect to River Phoenix. All right, moving right along, rules number dos. You ever been to like a crowded hospital and there's just a bunch of old people wasting everybody's time? It's like, just throw them out. From now on, old people go out in the trash.
Come trusty, put out your old.
All right, now lastly, rules number tres. I don't read books. But recently, somebody gave me a copy of Atlas Shrugging. And at first I was like, this is dumb. But then I read some of it. Turns out Man Ran's a pretty cool guy. All right, so now that I'm libertarian, the weak should always perish.
No mercy.
Okay, so moving right along. Up next, we have our 90s reference segment.
Oh, yes, I am so on board.
ever hear of a little movie called Jurassic Park?
Holy crap, I have heard of that.
How about that old safari grandpa guy?
Oh my god, I completely remember him!
Pretty sure that's actually an elderly Indiana Jones.
Oh my god, that's another movie that I used to watch.
That guy probably didn't get laid, but did dance alone to Spice Girls.
Oh my god, music that I know about, anything I might have done yet.
If you want to be my lover, you gotta get with my dinosaur friends.
Oh my god, I've heard of that as well. Now I feel good about myself and included. Yeah.
Who remembers Keenan and Kel?
Pitch me if I dream me. No, I get all of it.
Can't wait for the E! True Hollywood Story to find out what kind of booze he was mixing that orange soda.
I've heard of that as well. Who needs punchlines when you can just remember things?
Now let's have a moment of silence for Aaron. Oh. Hey, let's eat lunch.
Oh, but it's cold. Take out of the way. I'm getting to the oven.
Hey, what are you?
Hey, you munch.
Will you bugging me?
Give me that! How do you
hey,
like it?
Hey!
How do you like it? Oh.
Hey, will you come here and give me a hand?
Okay. Hey, boss! You ever heard of the Crisco cookbook written by a count?
Give me that. You ever heard of the Count of Monte Cristo? The Count of Monte Cristo is a classic. Oh, let's see. On February 24th, 1815, the Watchtower of Notre Dame de la Grande...
Notre Dame, what's that?
It's a church, you dummy. Signaled the arrival of the three master fairmen from Smyrna, Trusta, and Naples. The usual crowd of curious spectators... Has not Count just told us all that his human wisdom is contained in the three words, wait and hope? Oh, there. Hey, what happened to the other guy?
Haven't seen him.
Uh-oh.
He dead.
We gotta finish lunch.
Hey, this weekend, you want to go tail docking?
What's that, chasing girls?
No, it's burning the tails off of cows to make them easier to handle.
Well, I hope it doesn't cause rectal prolapse.
It does!
No, you do not break my vase. Okay, time to find the culprit. Was it you, Pa?
Nah, it wouldn't be me. I couldn't do that.
Oh, then was it you, Grapes?
Nah, of course it was me. I was at the liquor store.
Ah, you two boys. Of course it was you two.
All right, I confess. I was looking to get some money to get my brother's car out of the impound.
Oh, you do not break my vase, and you do not get your brother's car impounded. Oh, you should be ashamed.
I'm so sorry, Auntie. I was trying to fight my brother. We were roughhousing, and we broke your vase. I learned a valuable lesson today.
Well, then I guess my vase served its purpose. You two babies sure are a pair.
I tell you, I found a way to beat Obamacare.
What, did you buy yourself a witch doctor?
No, I just bought some beef from Walmart. Now I've got a year's worth of antibiotics.
Put on the powder! All right, hand me the light.
What's that?
The light.
What did you need to write?
I'll show you what I needed to write, you dummy. Now give me the light.
Right. Here you go.
No, the no light.
Oh, I am stuck.
Not the dildo, you dildo. The light. The new fresh light.
Need these?
Not these, you dummy.
Boss, I'm tangled.
Hey, you forgot the painting.
Oh. I got an idea.
What's that?
I can fix it.
Then let's see. Hey! Rubber, Lee, stubborn, stuck it there. Got an angry rubber, Lee, red legs, a pink and rubber. Now, what's next?
So I'm like, I'm not adopting a dog that doesn't have a disability. No one's gonna care about that on Instagram.
I wouldn't.
Why did I call in a park? You don't bring your car here! Ought to call him to sit!
It's fine. It's just homeless Gallagher. He lives in the park. You'll get used to him.
What? In the modern kitchen, there is a standard rule. For every kitchen task, you must have the rubber tool. It's not a slicer, not a dicer, not a chopper, not a hopper. Let's just not it!
Okay, go ahead, homeless Gallagher.
Was that the real Gallagher?
No one's really sure.
That's not.
You got the chips! I'm the dip!
Oh, whoa. Oh, oh my god! Oh.
What? What are you doing?
Oh, it's too dumb!
Where do I put the chips?
My butthole! Oh my god.
Hey, little help?
Why do they call it soccer? You're not hitting a woman! Yeah! Evening, ladies. Welfare, if you ask me, they're not faring very well. I've heard of butter on a roll, but that's Gallagher on a roll. Wait, I got candy.
Somewhere over the rainbow. Skies are blue, and the dreams that you care to dream.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana. Okay, I get it. You're gonna say orange, and I'm gonna say orange who, and you're gonna say orange. You're glad I didn't say banana?
Nope. Knock knock.
Who's there?
Orange.
Orange who?
Orange, you're glad I didn't spray you with the herbicide Agent Orange that was used during the Vietnam War to maim and kill nearly 400,000 people that was developed by Monsanto.
Dummy!